The words to the hymns are found on the parish website under St. Joseph's Church, Guelph, under Bulletin, for the 8:30 Mass. You can either print them out, actually weekly, because they're usually published by Friday, and bring them if you like to sing, or bring your book, and most of the songs are from here, or use your device. Please stand for the entrance hymn. In the Catholic Book of Worship, number 443, verses 1 and 3 of There's a Wideness in God's Mercy.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And my brothers and sisters in Christ, we come to the holy celebration by which we give worship to the Father through Christ in the Spirit, acknowledging our sins and the need of God's mercy, that we may walk always and now in his grace and in his goodness. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good.
Glory of God.
us pray. Show favor, O Lord, to your servants, and mercifully increase the gifts of your grace, that made fervent in faith, hope, and charity, they may be ever watchful in keeping your commands. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of prophet Jeremiah. Woe to the shepherds who destroy and scatter the sheep of my pasture, says the Lord. Therefore, thus says the Lord, the God of Israel, concerning the shepherds who shepherd my people. It is you who have scattered my flock and have driven them away, and you have not attended to them. So I will attend to you for your evil doing, says the Lord. Then I myself will gather the remnant of my flock out of all the lands where I have driven them, and I will bring them back to their fold, and they shall be fruitful and multiply. I will raise up shepherds over them who will shepherd them, and they shall not fear any longer or be dismayed. Nor shall any be missing, says the Lord. The days are surely coming, says the Lord, when I will raise up David for a righteous branch, and he shall reign as king and deal wisely, and shall execute justice and righteousness in the land. In his days, Judah will be saved, and Israel will live in safety, and this is the name by which he will be called. The Lord is our righteousness. The word of the Lord.
The responsorial psalm is number 158.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing and green are the pastures,
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, now in Christ Jesus, you who once were far off have been brought near by the blood of Christ. For he is our peace. In his flesh he has made both Jews and Gentiles into one, and has broken down the dividing wall, that is the hostility between us. He has abolished the law with its commandments and ordinances, that he might create in himself one new man in place of the two, thus making peace, and might reconcile both groups to God in one body through the cross, thus putting to death that hostility through it. So Christ Jesus came and proclaimed peace to you who were far off, and peace to those who were near. For through him both of us have access in one spirit to the Father. The word of the Lord.
With you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. The apostles returned from their mission. They gathered around Jesus and told him all that they had done and taught. He said to them, "Come away to a deserted place all by yourselves and rest a while." For many were coming and going, and they had even no leisure even to eat. They went away in the boat to a deserted place by themselves. Now many saw them going and recognized them, and they hurried there on foot from all the towns and arrived ahead of them. As Jesus went ashore, he saw a great crowd and had compassion for them, because they were like sheep without a shepherd, and he began to teach them many things. The Gospel of the Lord. So you can just imagine the scene. The apostles have come back from their missionary journey that Jesus set them on last week, and they're ready to tell, as we hear Jesus, all the good stuff that has happened to them. Jesus is ready to listen to the successes that they've had, and no doubt they had many successes. And Jesus is also wanting us to the apostles to hear any failures, the failures that they had. Because Jesus knows that with going out on a missionary journey, there's going to be successes, but there will be failures. And Jesus wants to hear about these. But not the only, Jesus just doesn't want to hear these things just to hear them speak. But Jesus also wants to encourage them. Because we all need that encouragement. Especially if things didn't go as well as they thought it would, or places where they wouldn't accept the message. So we need encouragement. And Jesus probably was counseling them as well, redirecting them when necessary. You know how it can be sometimes where we go and do something, it turns out well, but it could have turned out better. And then you talk to a friend, and a friend goes, "Yeah, that wasn't too bad, but what if you try it this way?" And in many ways, you can imagine Jesus doing the same thing. That the apostles have gone, "Oh, well, it was okay, Lord. It could have probably been better. Well, maybe we might want to try it this way." So Jesus is ready to help. And the same is true of us. Jesus makes that invitation to us as he made the invitation to the apostles, come to a deserted place with me. Why does Jesus say that? Because Jesus wants to hear our successes. When we go and pray in that deserted place, we shouldn't be afraid to say, thank you, Lord, for making this work out, or that work out. And also, we shouldn't be afraid to say, well, this didn't work out too well, or I keep falling into this sin, or what have you not. We have to have that open and honest relationship with Jesus Christ, as the apostles did and do. And this is why Jesus wants us, invites us to a deserted place, so he can hear us, our successes and failures, to give us encouragement, to give us counsel where counsel is needed, to redirect us where we need redirection. Jesus is there to help us. So though what that means is, when we go to a deserted place and be with the Lord, yes, there's an amount of verbal prayer, but we'd also need quiet, just to be, sit still and be with the Lord. Because it is in the Lord, it is in the silence, as Elijah found out on the mountain, that the Lord is there to speak, there to guide, there to bring encouragement. And God wants us, Jesus wants to do the same thing for us. So it is important that in our everyday life, that we take that time to find a place to be with the Lord and rest. Yes, rest physically, because physical relaxation is important. We need that. But we also need that spiritual rest, where we have that time just to sit with the Lord and allow the Lord to speak to us. And what that spiritual rest does for us, it hopefully calms us down a little bit. Hopefully it gives us, in our everyday life, in our secular life, in our spiritual life, where that spiritual rest, when we listen to the Lord speak to us in our hearts, we get that promise of the life to come. Because I think sometimes we miss out on that promise. We think that today and here is the be-all, end-all, where it's the life to come. So when we have that spiritual rest in the Lord goes, okay, you're doing okay, don't worry about it, but just remember, your ultimate goal is to be with me in heaven. And hopefully when we take that time for a spiritual rest, when we bring all these things to the Lord, we find inner peace in life. And after all, isn't that what we're searching for? We're searching for that inner peace. There's many self-help books to help you. They don't help a lot, but they're there to help you. But what Jesus offers is the kind of peace that quiets the mind and heart, even in the midst of turmoil. I think I've used this story here before, I'm not sure, but it's a good story, so I'm going to use it again. You're welcome. When I was a deacon, some things were happening. And it was like, okay, I got to go in front of the Blessed Sacrament. And then about a couple of days later, I had my spiritual director with my spiritual director at the seminary, and I told him all that was happening, and I told him, look, I went in front of the Blessed Sacrament. And my spiritual director said, so what happened? I said, peace. And his great line to me was, don't knock peace. And this is what Jesus offers. And I think in our spiritual life, I hope, we've all experienced that at times, where things are going haywire in our everyday life, but we come in front of the Lord, we sit in front of the Lord, allow the Lord to listen to us, allow the Lord to help us in our silence, and we feel that inner peace. Yes, the things may be still going nuts, but we have that inner peace. No one will be okay. And that is what Jesus offers us. And that is why we need that spiritual rest. That's kind of peace that surpasses all human understanding, where, okay, things are not the best, but I'm okay, because I'm with the Lord in the silence, and the Lord has given me courage The Lord has given me the ability, the counsel, to go forward. What does that do for us? It does exactly the same thing that it did for the apostles today. Growth in our trust for God. Because ultimately, that's what it's all about. Growth in trusting God. This is why we need to have that spiritual rest. This is why we need to go to a deserted place and just be quiet and let the Lord speak to us. Because we are in a battle every day, right? We're in a battle against temptations. We're in a battle against difficulties. We're in a battle overcoming obstacles that stop us from going closer to Jesus. We're in a battle to live our mission that Jesus has given us at baptism that we spoke about last week, to go out into the world. The only way in which we can overcome this battle is to come to the Lord in quiet prayer. Because it's easy to get down, but be down from the struggle. But if we spend the time with the Lord in prayer, if we meet the Holy Spirit regularly, in many ways, you can say, to use today's language, that when we come to the quiet of the deserted place with the Lord and allow the Lord to speak to us, He is our head coach. He is our personal trainer. He will help us. Are we open? Because if we allow, if you want to use the wording, as I said, Jesus to be our personal trainer, our coach, to allow Him to guide us instead of us trying to guide the Lord, we'll be able to win the battles. We will be able to overcome obstacles, or at the very least, have the peace of heart, mind, and knowledge, and the comfort to know that God will get us through it if we don't. So what happens when we go to a deserted place with Jesus Christ and allow the Lord to help us in silent prayer? Our faith vision is renewed. Our injuries and hurts are healed. Our weakness is strengthened. And our victory is assured.
We now confess the faith which has been handed down faithfully throughout the ages, which we will not abandon, because in this faith we find that security that Father spoke of. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, on Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the heart, and life everlasting. Amen. We bring to our Lord our needs and our prayers, and we pray for the church, the world, and for all those things we need at this time of our life.
The response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the church may be faithful to its call to preach repentance and the good news of Jesus Christ to all people, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who govern us, that they may have the heart and mind of a good shepherd and keep the protection of human life as their first priority, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
for the soul of Martha Prezel, whom this Mass is offered for, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who suffer because of injustice, discrimination, or hardship because of race or religion may deepen their faith in God and experience His protection, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That men and women may generously open their hearts to God's invitation to serve His people through the priesthood and religious life, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who have died, especially Ed Pringlemeyer, may experience the peace and life of Christ in the heavenly kingdom, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord God above, we pray to you with sincerity of heart, and we know that we do not always make our prayers perfectly clear, for we do not sometimes even know what to pray for. But we know that you want us to ask, and in asking, we trust that you will grant that which we need to ultimately lead us to the kingdom where you live and reign forever and ever. Amen.
The offertory hymn is number 490, Like a Shepherd.
Like a shepherd he feeds his flock, gathers the lambs in his arms, holding them carefully.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands. Praise and glory his name for our good and the good of all this holy church.
Let us pray, O God, when the one perfect sacrifice brought to completion various offerings of the law, accept, we pray, the sacrifice from your faithful servants, and make it holy as you bless the gifts of Abel, that what each has offered to the honor of your majesty may benefit the salvation of all. We make this our prayer through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let it. It is right and just, our duty now and always, to ever give you thanks, eternal God, O Heavenly Father, Almighty God, for when your children were scattered afar by sin, through the blood of your Son and the power of the Spirit, you gathered them to yourself, that a people formed as one by the unity of the Trinity made the body of Christ and the temple of the Holy Spirit. Might to the praise of be manifest as the church. And so, with the choirs of angels and with joy, we proclaim.
Holy.
Created rightly gives you praise, for through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you gave life to all things and make them holy. You never cease to gather a people to yourself, that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection, and ascension into heaven, as we look forward to his second coming, we offer in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son may be filled with his Holy Spirit and become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, our patron Saint Joseph, and all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, your servant, Pope Francis, our Bishop Douglas, and Auxiliary Wayne, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people that you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this, your family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed brothers and sisters, to all who are pleasing to you at the passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom, for there we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. And at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, O Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be free from sin, coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her the peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And we offer to one another the sign of our Lord's peace. Peace of Christ be with you. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed those called to the supper of the Lamb. If it's not been mentioned, I think it was, but I'll repeat it. We will now say the body of Christ individually, as was the case before the COVID. And for those wishing communion on the tongue, they may. But Father has asked that we come up to the priest only to receive the Eucharist on the tongue, if you wish to. May the body and blood of Christ keep us for everlasting life. Amen.
communion hymn is Take and Eat, number 6.8.
Take and eat, this is my body.
I've never said Mass at 10:30 here yet, or 10:15, so a lot of people probably don't even know who I am, Father Don Sanvito. I'm born in Guelph, but I haven't been here for 50-some years, that's for sure. So the first time actually I've been here to St. Joe's, and I'm very appreciative of the welcome I've had, and also that Father Bergsma was so kind to take me in to live here at St. Joe's. I'll be helping where I can. I'm not the associate priest, I'm a retired priest. If I'm the new associate, believe me, you got the raw deal, I can tell you that much. But I'll be here in whatever way Father needs me down the road, you know. I'm very glad to be here with the people of St. Joseph, even as a retired priest, and as I said, however Father would like to use me, I'd be always more than happy, but I know he also wants to respect the fact that I am now officially a retired priest, so you don't have to worry about me being the new associate. I wouldn't be able to merit that distinction at this stage of the ballgame, that's for sure. Thank you, and God bless you. Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you've imbued with the heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may the blessings of Almighty God be upon you and remain with you both now and forevermore. The Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth in the peace of Christ. The Mass is ended. Thanks be to God.
Our recessional hymn is number 481, Be Not Afraid.
You shall know.